Hey everyone, welcome back. It's good to see you. How's everyone doing? Good, good. So I know the past couple videos have been more of process, like drawing videos. This one, I wanted to get back to the 12 animation principles. Last time we talked about squash and stretch. This time we're gonna talk about overlapping action and follow through. Now there's gonna be a little bit of squash and stretch in here, but for the most part, we're gonna talk about that overlapping animation. So let's get to it. So here we are in Animate CC. It's part of the Creative Cloud Suite by Adobe. And this used to be known as Flash. Most of my career was built off of Flash. I was a Flash animator and developer for a long time. I've done projects for a lot of really cool companies like Disney, DreamWorks, and blah, blah, blah. A bunch of really cool projects that I got to work on because of Flash, now Animate. So let's take a look at this animation first, and then we can take a look at each frame. An important thing to note is take a look at how absolutely rough the animation is. Right now I'm trying to work on the flow, the animation of it. I'm not trying to get bogged down by all of the details that make a drawing really pretty. I'm just trying to work on timing and a good flow for this animation. So in Animate, it's not an automatic loop. If you look up here in the center, there is a loop button. So I'm gonna click on that. And then you get these brackets. I'm gonna grab this left side and drag it all the way over to the left. So now everything that is in within these two brackets will be included in the loop, which is a powerful feature because if I just want to work on just this little bit of this animation here, I can just loop here and figure that out. Hit pause. I'm gonna stretch this out for the entire animation, and now I'm gonna hit return, and now we see we got our guy swinging from this rope. I'm not gonna lie, I am still totally in love with Spider-Man, Spider-Verse, so this is kind of, you know what I mean. I got Spider-Man on the brain. So let's take a look at this frame by frame. And we see that the head is coming down first. And it's basically leading the animation. And we're gonna come up to the top. And this is the first part of the follow through, right? So the head is gonna reach the top and it's going to slow way down, which is another animation principle, which is ease in, ease out. But we'll talk about that more later. The head starts to make its way down and the body and especially the feet follow through and now get pulled down. There's a little squash and stretch on the feet, as you can see. That's gonna swing back down and around and up. And again, it's going to ease in, ease out the follow through. And there's a third part of this specific animation principle. So first we have overlapping animation, which is the head is basically one part of the animation. The body and the feet are another two parts of the animation. So that's called overlapping. And the follow through, you see there where the head starts making its way back through. And imagine, even if this guy was standing still and he had on a scarf, right? That scarf would be also a follow through animation included in the overlapping animation. And then if the guy started walking, the guy's neck would drag the scarf along. So he would have this big flowing scarf in the wind that his body is dragging. So here we can see a little bit of dragging. If you look, if these are the character's hands and this is the bottom of the web, rope or web or whatever you want to call it, you see how that's his hands are initiating the drag of that web. And when I was animating this, when I was putting the marks down for the end of this rope, I wasn't being too careful because really what I wanted to do was show that this thing was being dragged and it was fluttering in the wind. And if you could imagine this guy's hands being someone's head and the end of this web is a scarf, it kind of helps illustrate what I was talking about with drag. And again, the head here is dragging the body and the body is dragging the legs, which then drag the feet. There's a few things I wanted to show you guys while we're here in Flash. I'm sorry, that's gonna happen all the time. In Animate, I'm gonna come up here to the top left of the timeline. I'm gonna hit a new layer. We'll go over all of the tools on a different video. Right now, we're just talking animation principles, but you come down here to the brush tool and you just start to draw. Obviously, the stroke is being put down. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit this little target button with the pencil in the middle that says use pressure. I'm gonna click on that. I'm on a Wacom Cintiq right now. So if you have any kind of tablet, any kind of Cintiq, any kind of pressure sensitive anything, you click that button. And now, if I just start touching and the harder I press, the thicker the line, the lighter I press, the thinner the line. So just like good old fashioned back when Flash, and I did that on purpose, in Flash, you'd be able to click on this and now you have the shape. And if you drag, you're able to mess around with the stroke. There's this new, relatively new functionality. I'm gonna go to the brush tool. I'm gonna make sure that the pressure sensitive or use pressure is turned on. And there's this thing here called the object drawing button. I'm gonna click that and now I can put down a shape. But if I click on the black arrow, which basically says select everything that's connected to this thing, if I click on it, this is something that continued to happen to me until I got help. What I'm gonna do is hit the brush button and I'm gonna come over here and make sure that it says paint normal. So now I'm gonna select that shape and hit delete. I'm gonna hit B, which is a shortcut for the brush tool. I'm gonna make sure that the use pressure is turned on. I'm gonna make sure that object drawing is turned on. And again, on the right side in the properties panel, I'm gonna make sure that paint normal is selected. It's the only selection over here that lets this functionality happen. So now if I draw a shape, I'm gonna hit the black arrow tool and click on it. Now you can see that this shape has a square around it. I can click and drag that shape. Why does that become helpful? Number one, I'm gonna get back to the brush tool and I'm going to, why did that? Oh, that's why, because I have that selected. I'm gonna make sure I have the brush tool and I'm gonna turn off object drawing. And if I make a shape, now if I draw another shape and yet another shape, all of these will become the same shape. Sometimes that's useful, not all the time. Let's delete this guy. If I get the brush tool, make sure that object drawing is on, and again make sure paint normal is on, and I draw a head, let's say. So now I can move this head all over the place, and I can come back and draw a shape of a body. That's its own shape, so now I can actually take that shape and move it around. And as you saw there, if I zoom in, if I click on the edge of this, if it's deselected, I can still go in and adjust the edges of the shape. But if I select it, again, I can move it. And now you can see where you're able to draw a shape, two shapes actually, and then just affect them in different ways. So I'm going to delete those shapes, get the brush tool, make sure all my selections are properly set, and I'm going to draw the head. And if I wanted to animate, like for example, lock that layer. If I wanted to animate this guy, I can go here, set the head, go to another frame. If I hit F6, I can then move that head. Go down one more, hit F6, and move that head. So we can see how that's starting to animate. I'm going to do another few more just to... Here's another shortcut. If I select a frame, hit Alt on Mac, I believe it's about the same thing on PC too, and just click, drag, and let go, all of these frames will then be set, right? So now that head is not moving, but if I go to that frame, now I can move it, go to the next frame, move it again, and just, oops, select it and then move it. Now you see how the consistency of the size of my fake Spider-Man's head starts to animate. This is where this technique comes in super handy. If I have the body set, I'm going to go to the next one. I'm going to turn on onion skinning and keep drawing the body. Okay, so now we have that set. Turn off onion skinning and just flip through these frames. So now you're starting to see basically how rough animation works. You're just throwing down some shapes to obviously to get the feel for it. But with this object drawing tool, let's say that body isn't perfectly where I want it to be. Now I can highlight it. That box is set. This object drawing tool is it's almost like, if you're familiar with Animate, you know what graphic symbols are and you know what movie clips are. This is a step between the shape tool, or just shapes in general, and a graphic symbol. So now I can move that guy there, go to the next frame, move it. Gotta make sure it's selected, move it down. And you see how you can get the adjustments super fast. I'm gonna create a new layer just to show you what would happen if we don't have that object drawing mode turned on. I'm going to draw a head and a body. I'm gonna go to the next frame. I'm gonna hit F7 now because I want a blank keyframe. And I'm gonna draw the head and the body. F7, head, body. And remember how we were able to take the different shapes and move it previously? With object drawing turned off, now when I click to select it, it selects the whole thing. So I can't move the body by itself. The entire thing moves. Which some folks, it makes sense for them to just come in here and draw the entire thing. And all that is fine and good. But when you're trying to get the rough animation down and you're trying to get all the body parts properly placed, let's just say we have arms. We have arms that are here. And maybe this arm is just a little bit out of place. Now I can actually move that out of the way. Or if I want it down here, go to the next one. And again, I'm able to adjust the different shapes with little to no drama. And here's another tip that I learned from Chris Georginas. If I hit the brush tool, and I make sure that the object drawing is on, I'm going to come over here to the color panel and I'm going to drop that down to about a 40. Why? Because it just, for me, being able to have the different shapes that you can see through, it just kind of helps my brain make sense of what's happening. It's almost like drawing with a marker. It's a preference thing. You don't necessarily have to do that. You just crank that alpha up to 100 and you can draw as much as you want. I prefer using, like I said, about 40%. Come on here and then you're able to just really get after it. So now that we've broken that down, let's go ahead and take a look at the animation. And this is a rough animation. This is just, like I said before, we're just setting timing, we're getting a good feel for the animation, making sure that that the animation flows properly. And the hands are connected to the web, and the head is basically leading the animation. The follow-through of the body is there. We have the drag of the little part of the web that comes through the guy's hands and the feet. But you might be thinking, this doesn't look like a complete cartoon. And it's not. This is just for timing and the animation. This would be called a rough animation. The next step would be taking these frames and actually drawing them and finalizing them and doing the cleanup process. And we'll talk about that in the next video. But for now, I hope you learned something. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you know anyone that might like this video or might learn something from this video, share it with them and subscribe and get everyone that you know to subscribe so we can do this every week. I love doing this and I'm just so excited to share all this stuff with you guys. All right, see you in the next one.